which is applicable for symmetric circuits. Your differential amplifier is symmetric if you consider the y-axis, right? It's symmetric, both the side. So for half circuit analysis, this is the simple concept. Now if you have a symmetric circuit, say D1 and D2, two devices are there, which has input V in1 and V in2, okay? Now say your V in1 and V in2 changes from equilibrium by delta V in positive and in negative side as well minus delta V in. So say your V in 1 changes value, and this is your V0, okay? So your V in 1 changes value from V0 to V0 plus V in plus delta V in. Your V in 1 changes value from V0 to V0 plus delta V in, and V in 2 changes its value from V0 to V0 minus delta V in. Now, according to this theory, if the circuit in this condition remains linear, then the potential at Vp is always constant. Okay, so there is a proof also given to this particular concept in Razavi book, so you can check it. I'm not showing it here, it's very straightforward proof wherein they have considered a voltage source connected to a resistance, and there is another resistance connected to a voltage, so a symmetric circuit, say it is V in 1, it is V in 2, okay, it is say R1, it is R2. Now they have calculated the potential at this common point Vp, and they have shown the same thing. Okay, simple KVL, if you apply it, can be proved. So if you check it there, probably you'll get to know. However, this is what the concept is. Now apply the same concept in your differential amplifier. So you can divide your differential amplifier in two different parts. So left side and right side is exactly same, and in this case your VP point, that is this point, is grounded, which is in common potential you can consider. So that's why you have taken VGS1 in the input side of M1, say it is M1. So in the M2 side it is minus VGS1. So your VGS2 is basically minus VGS1. Okay, this is the consideration. And why this is grounded? Because we are considering only AC analysis. So your all DC biases have been removed. All DC biases have been removed. Okay, so remember this one. Now your Vx by VGS1, simple, this side is common source amplifier kind. So your Vx, which is output at the M1 side, Vx by VGS1, VGS1 is input, it will be minus GM1 RD parallel R01. This is your output resistance of the MOSFET. Similarly, Vy divided by minus VGS1, because your VGS2 is equal to minus VGS1, will be minus GM into RD parallel R02. So you will get Vx minus Vy divided by VGS1 will be minus GM1 parallel RD, GM1 into RD parallel R01 plus GM2 into RD parallel R02 or R02, whatever you say. Okay, just doing simple calculations and considering GM1, GM2 is equal to GM and R01, R02 is equal to R0. Why you are considering all this? Because your M1 and M2 are exactly same. These are same type of MOSFETs that you are using. So these values are supposed to be same. So this is not a bad assumption. So if you do this, you will find your Vx minus Vy divided by 2 VGS1 is equal to GM into RD plus R0. So it will be actually Vx minus Vy divided by VGS1 is equal to minus 2 into, because these are repeating, right? So this plus this will be 2 into this. Then you can write Vx minus Vy divided by 2 VGS1 is equal to GM, just shifting the 2 from this side to this side, you'll find this one. Now your 2 VGS1 is basically VGS1 minus VGS2. Remember, VGS2 is minus VGS1. So basically this is 2 VS1 only. So this is what is giving you V out by VDIF. Now by this calculation also, you got the differential gain is minus GMRD. R0 is very high, so you can neglect R0 from here. Previously, why you did not get this R0 in here? Because you did not consider this M1, M2 parallel R0, you did not consider. If you would have considered, you would have got RD parallel R0. That time we did not consider, we neglected it in the very beginning, saying R0 is very high, which is true. So this is a good assumption. So here also, if you do the take the same assumption, this is minus GM into RD only. Okay. Now, symmetry can be achieved even if the circuit is not fully differential. What does that mean? That means, say if your symmetry is not maintained in terms of voltages, okay? Because what was the condition here? VGS1 is in one side, on the other side is minus VGS1. So this differential symmetry, if it is not maintained in your circuit, then also you can apply half circuit analysis. That is what it means. Okay, now say if it is different, say it is V in one this side, V in two this side. Now you can write equivalent circuit similar to this. So what you have done, you have divided this V in one in the input side as V in one by two, V in one by two, and added to opposite polarity V in divided V in two divided by two in the input side. So you have done V in 2 divided by 2 minus V in 2 divided by 2. If you see, the polarity is opposite. This is plus minus, this is minus plus. So there is no effect of this. Just for the sake of calculation, we have added this side. Okay, we have added V in 2 components in this side, but in opposite polarity. Similar thing we have done for V in 2 in this side. Now in this case, you have added opposite polarity V in 1 by 2, V in 1 by 2. So essentially that doesn't mean anything. Now if you take combination of V in by 2 and V in 2 by 2 in both the sides, you will end up with V in 1 minus V in 2 divided by 2 as one this thing source, and the other source will be V in 1 plus V in 2 divided by 2. Similarly, in the output side, one will be V in 2 minus V in 1 divided by 2, and the other one will be V in 1 plus V in 2 divided by 2. So, two common source in the input and output side. If you can add, you will find again the symmetry is hold. What does that mean? That means minus V in 1 minus V in 2 divided by 2, which is just similar to this, just a minus sign came in front. Similar VGS minus VGS. So you got this, but at the cost of an extra common voltage. Now this V in 1 and V in 2 can be written as this way. From the input and output side, it is very evident. Now this is your difference signal, the minus part, and this is your common mode signal. Why common mode? Because this is common for both the sources. That's why we can make a common source of this magnitude for both of them, other than keeping it separate. Now again, use the superposition theorem. You will get your Vx and Vy value is something like this. So just apply the superposition theorem that I have applied previously. So it will give you Vx and Vy value similar to this. So your V0 is Vx minus Vy, or V01 or VO1 minus VO2, and your VD will be VID, which we also know as VID. So it's V in 1 minus V in 2. So if you now calculate VO by VID, this will be minus half GM1 into RD parallel R01 plus GM2 RD parallel R02. So this gains, we already have seen, we get this type of gains, right? For this type of differential amplifiers. So this time again you consider GM1, GM2 which is equal to GM and R01, R02 which is equal to R0. Then you will get V0 by VID is equal to minus GM RD parallel R0. So here also you will get the same value which is known as differential mode gain. So AVDM, that's why I have written AVDM. However, as your M1 and M2 is very identical, common mode gain will be 0 because input side, if you only take this common mode signal, this will cancel out. VIN1 minus VIN2 will be 0. Similarly, your VO1 minus VO2 will also be 0. So your input and output both are 0, so your common mode gain is 0. Is that clear? So you can see these things in book as well. Now there is another thing which is current source ISS is not ideal. What happens? You have a current source, right? For DC biasing, you have a current source. What if this current source is not ideal? What does that mean? An ideal current source has a shunting resistance equal to infinite. So it produces an infinite resistance. It offers an infinite resistance. So it's basically an open circuit. But in practice, you will not get an ideal current source. So it will have a finite value of resistance. Even if it is a current source, it will offer a finite value of resistance. Now, let us consider RSS is the value of that finite of that current source. RSS is the finite value of resistance for that current source. And your common mode signal is VIN CM. Now, we already have seen the common mode gain is equal to 0 in case of differential amplifier. But what if your biasing current source is not ideal? What happens? So let us consider in this case the common mode input is VIN CM. You have the RSS value as a resistance, which is because of your non-ideal current source ISS. So this is your VX and VY value. These are two RD values. So your VX and VY, what will be the condition of VX and VY? Because it's a symmetric circuit, your VX and VY will be similar or same, equal, which also means your V output 1 and V output 2 is also equal. So your VX minus VY is 0. V01 minus V02 is equal to 0. So you can consider this as a short circuit as it is considered here. Both the inputs are same in M1 and M2, and M1 and M2 is 100% identical. That is what your consideration is. So you can directly connect this one, right? And if you see this part, you'll find that your RD values are in complete parallel circuit. So in your equivalent circuit, this parallel RD will become RD by 2, just considering the equivalent circuit, equivalent resistance of two same resistances. So it will give you the resistance by 2, right? Because both the resistances are equal. Now, we can also combine these two MOSFETs. These two MOSFETs are completely identical, and they are connected, their input VG is connected. Now in that case, what is the consideration? If you are getting, say, IDS from here, IDS from here, so what will be the IDS in here? Two IDS, your current will be doubled. And that effect comes because your width, channel width is getting doubled, which is equivalent to the effect of channel width getting doubled, right? Rest of the other parameters of IDS, you cannot just consider. When both of them are in parallel, if you see they are parallel, right? So you can consider the both the width of MOSFETs are just getting added, and that's why you are getting an higher current compared to the single separate one. Okay, Now if you do this, you will see here it is written, both the widths are actually adding up for both the MOSFETs, which is giving 2W width, because omega, W1 and W2 both are same because it's are identical MOSFETs. So you can write W plus W, which is giving you 2W. And current also, both in both the sides, the current also will be similar. So total current here you are getting ISS, the DC current. So in both the sides, your current will be ISS by 2 because it's completely symmetric. Now you know that GM value is equal to 2 into beta n dash W by L into IDS. Now if you consider the GM M1 M2, this is M1 plus M2, it will be 2 beta n dash 2 W by L, because this is now increased. The equivalent effect shows that this is increased, so it's 2W. And your IDS value is basically now ISS by 2. Okay, so it is basically 2 into ISS by 2. Remember, your IDS value now is ISS by 2. That one you have to consider. Your total current is ISS, but in both the symmetric circuit, it's ISS by 2, which is equal, well, equivalent to IDS in each circuit. So you will get a GM1 is equal to GM2. If you consider both of them is equal to GM, because identical circuit, so GM M1, GM M2 will be equal, and this is GM value. Then in this case, you will get GM M1 plus M2 equal to 2GM. So your GM value doubled because of this parallel circuit, because of this. So it is basically the equivalent effect. You are not, you can't push two devices physically, right? But the equivalent effect is giving you 2GM. Now for common source amplifier with source degeneration, what is the VCM value? V0 by VNCM. So it will give you just like previous case. If you apply the same formula, you will get the value is something like this. But in this case, your GM is replaced by 2GM. So your AVCM is basically GMRD divided by 2RSGM. If you consider 2RSGM is much, much higher than 1, which is the case. This assumption is good. So you will get a value of minus RD by 2RSS, right? Now, if your RSS value is infinite, if your current source is ideal, then this value will be infinite. Then you again get AVCM is equal to 0. This is what you got previously, but if it is not ideal, your RSS has a finite value. So your AVCM will be also a finite value. It's not infinite for RSS finite value. So your CMRR, that is known as common mode rejection ratio, which is basically the differential gain divided by common mode gain, will be a finite value. And why this finite value is coming? Because of the non-ideal current source. Okay, so this is what I wanted to discuss.